Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salam ala ashrafi khalqillah Sayyidina Muhammadin ibn Abdillahi wa alihi wa sallim tasliman kathira. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi awzi'ni an ashkura ni'mataka allati an'amta 'alayya wa 'ala walidayya wa an a'mala salihan tardah wa aslih li fi dhurriyyati inni tubtu ilayka wa inni min al-muslimin. My dear brothers and sisters in iman, Abu Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, said that the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said in a hadith, inna Allah azza wa jal qal, that Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So this hadith is hadith Qudsi. And there's a difference between a prophetic hadith and a hadith Qudsi. A prophetic hadith is the word of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But a hadith that is called Qudsi, literally a message from Allah related to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Jibreel alayhi salam. So the words are Jibreel's word. Allah will give him the message and he will phrase the message in his words and the Prophet will relate it to us. So here the Prophet says, Inna Allah Azza wa Jalla qal, Allah Almighty said, Man aza li waliyan falagad adhantahu bilharb. Man aada li waliyan faqad adhantuhu bilharb. Whosoever take animosity against anyone of my awliya, I will declare war against them. This is very serious. Adawa in Arabic meaning animosity. So if suddenly there is somebody whom Allah loves and Allah is close to them and they are close to Allah and you treat them with animosity, Allah says, I'm going to declare war against you. And then he goes and says, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ أَدَاءِ مَا افْتَرَطَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Anyone of my servant will never do something more important that I love than that which I made compulsory for them. Allah loves you when you pray your 5 daily prayers. It is fard. Allah loves you when you pray your Jum'ah. It is fard. Allah loves you when you pay your zakah, when you fast your Ramadan, when you perform your Hajj, when you are kind to your parents. These are all fara'id. These are all compulsory acts. When you do them, Allah loves you. Hence he says, there is nothing more beloved to me than when I see my servant adhering to my command of that which I made fard, compulsory. وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حتى أحبه. However, after my servants accomplish what I have made compulsory and they begin in their own free time to do extra, optional worship. For example, Salah, Dhuhr is 4, Jum'ah is 2. But you can pray as much as you like before and after. There are times where Salah is not allowed. After you pray your Fajr prayer, until after Ishraq. When you pray your Asr, until after sunset. Other than that, anytime, day and night, you can stand up and pray 2, 4, 10, 100, 1,000. Allah loves it. If you are doing it genuinely, as a means of drawing yourself closer to Allah. This is called Nafila. So Allah will love you to see you doing more of this nafila. He says, Hatta uhibbuhu. This person who does extra salah, extra fasting, extra charity, extra goodness, the more they do, the more close they are coming to me, until they come a time when I love them. فَإِنْ أَحْبَبْتُهُ. And if I love the person, if the time comes and I love them, كُنْتُ سَمَعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ, I become his hearing, through which he hears. وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصُرُ بِهِ, and his sight through which he sees. وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطُشُ بِهَا, and his hand in which he works to earn his living. وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا, and his leg on which he walks. فَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي عَبْدِي أَعْطَيْتَهُ. These servants, when he asks me, I will give them whatever they want. وَلَئِنْ إِسْتَعَاذَنِي أَعَسْتَهُ. And if they seek refuge in me, or they want help from me, they will find me there to give them refuge and help them. وَمَا تَرَدَّدْتُ عَنْ شَيْءٍ أَنَا فَاعِلُهُ وَمَا تَرَدَّدْتُ عَنْ شَيْءٍ أَنَا فَاعِلُهُ تَرَدُّدِي عَنْ نَفْسِ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَكْرَهُ الْمَوْتِ وَأَكْرَهُ مُسَاءَتَهُ. And I had never hesitated in doing anything with my servants, only one thing, that my servants, they hate to die, but they have to die, and I don't like to see them in that position. Now when Allah says, I become your hearing, your sight, your hand, your leg, you're not going to be him subhanahu wa ta'ala, but what it means, that Allah will give you from his power that which will make you different than others. Allah began by saying, whosoever become an enemy to my wali or awliya, I declare war against them. And then he says, if my servant does anything I love, it does the compulsory act. So for a person to be a wali, those compulsory acts, they are like primary school. They are done. They will do their prayer and establish it properly. Their fasting, their zakah, their hajj. They will do it with knowledge. And they are diligent in doing it. But they are not going to stop there. Because they love what they are doing. They spend more time to do extra. Allah said, pray dhuhr four. They pray more before and after. You see, every Friday when we come here, after Jum'ah is finished, especially in the Hanafi Masajid, a lot of the people stand up and pray more. We come from North Africa, East Africa, we follow Imam Malik, we don't pray after Jum'ah. We leave straight away. We go home and pray at home. So that, because Allah said in the Quran, intashiru fil ard. But Abu Hanifa said, if you have a chance and you cannot go to your home, pray. So you see them praying a lot of extra nafil. Some of our people question it. Why are they doing this too much prayer? Allah loves it. The more you pray, Allah loves you. The more you are charitable, Allah loves you. The more goodness you do, Allah loves you. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger peace be upon him says, من آذى لي وليا فقد استحل محاربتي. من عادى لي وليا, whosoever taken animosity against my wali, he has given me permission to fight him. As if you are saying to Allah, I'm fighting you. أستغفر الله العظيم. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu was sitting in the masjid of Rasulullah. In the olden days, the grave of the Prophet was open. There is not like now, you cannot see it. Everybody can see the grave there. So Ma'ad ibn Jabal, the companion, was sitting next to the grave, crying and crying his heart out. Umar ibn al-Khattab came next to him and said, "Ma yubkika ya Mu'az? Why do I see you crying like this?" Mu'az radiallahu ta'ala anhu said to him, "Yubkini shay'un sami'tuhu min Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I hear something from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam making me cry today. I heard him saying, Inna yasir al-riya'i shirk. Inna yasir al-riya'i shirk. A little bit of showing off is shirk. When you show off anything, in any way, materially or spiritually, Allah doesn't like it. Allah said, الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاؤُونَ. Those who show off, Allah doesn't like them. They will go to wail. He said, I heard the Prophet says, even if you do a little bit of showing off, is equivalent to associating others with Allah. That's why I'm crying. Maybe when I'm doing my things, I'm showing off, I'm worried. وَإِنَّ مَنْ عَادَ أَوْلِيَاءِ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ بَارَضَ اللَّهُ بِالْمُحَارَبَةِ. And whosoever take animosity against the awliya of Allah, he has indeed declared war against Allah. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. The question for me, who are these awliya? Because today I see in our ummah debate and discussion in the social media, and they say things that make me cringe. People talking about the greatest scholars of Islam whom we look up to and all the knowledge we have gained is from them. I heard one of them say, Imam Malik is just a man. So who is he? I heard somebody else say, people say, Sayyid Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, who is he? These people are only acknowledged because of what they have done and what they have left. All the knowledge today that is written and in all universities, Quranic school, institution of Islam, the books that are being taught is their books. And even the modern people who are writing today, they are only taking from their books. They are not bringing anything new. And Rasulullah sallam says, those who leave knowledge, as long as people are acknowledging it, learning from it, putting it in practice or teaching it, their books of deeds is still open and they are receiving good deeds. So when somebody says, who is Imam Malik? Allahu Akbar. He is the first man to write the book of fiqh in Islam. Al-Khalifa Harun al-Rashid, when he heard about it, he sent for him to come to him. The Imam says, I can't. I never leave Medina. I don't want to die outside Medina. I can't leave the Prophet ﷺ. So the Imam came to him in the masjid, the Amir. When Harun al-Rashid came to the masjid, everybody is, wow, the leader, the Amir. Imam Malik was at home. He says, who is this Malik? I invite him, he doesn't come to me. Ana Amirul Mu'mineen. I come to his masjid, he's not there. He sent for him. Tell them to come to the Amir in the masjid. They came back and said, he's ill. He's a good man. He realized one of the duties of the Muslim when your brother is sick to go and visit him. So he took all his people and went. When they came to the door and they knocked, a young woman opened the door and says, come in. He became very upset. How can a woman welcome me? Where is the Imam? I am the Amir. So he went inside. He sat on the chair. And he sat on the chair where the teacher sat, Imam Malik. Because he's the Amir. The Imam took a long time and the Amir was so upset. By the time the Imam came in, sat on the floor, humbly putting his head down, he says, what is this? Ana Amirul Mu'mineen. I invite you, you don't come to me. I come to your lesson in the masjid, you are not there. I sent for you, okay, you are ill, but how could you make us wait? He said, I knew that you came to ask me about what the Prophet said and what I have written in my book. And I will never sit and utter a word the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said until I refresh my wudu and change my clothes and put my turban on. And then I will relate it. The Amir said to him, recite what the Prophet said. He said, قَالَ رَسُولَ سَلَّمْ مَنْ تَوَاضَعَ لِلَّهِ رَفَعَهُ. Whosoever humbled himself before Allah, Allah will raise them. The Amir took himself and sat on the floor. He realized the man knows what he's talking about. How can somebody living today coming and criticizing a man? First of all, the Prophet said, anybody who dies, good or bad, only mention what the good they have done. You have no excuse. There is no permission for you to talk about anybody who is dead, even if they were the most evilest. Hitler was a very evil man, according to the history. But why should I talk about him? Nothing to do with me. Why? He's dead. Between him and Allah, there is a hisab. There is a judgment day. I just need to look after myself. يَوْمَ يَأْتِينَا فَرْدًا. When you will come to us single, alone, nobody is going to be beside you. How can I speak about Imam Malik or Abu Hanifa or Abdul Ghadir al-Jailani? These are people whom our Muslim historians, leave alone the scholars of Islam, they said, these were called the Awliya. When you talk evil against them, Allah will declare a war against you. Few years back, when the Arab Spring was taking place, I heard of a lot of people going to some countries, and in Tunisia, they went to one of the biggest masjids, and inside there is the grave of one of the greatest Muslim scholars, Ibn Zarruq, and they dug his grave. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Even the kuffar will not dig a grave. They respect the grave. لِلْغَبْرِ حُرْمَ. لِلْغَبْرِ حُرْمَ. For this grave, there is sanctity. You cannot just come and sit on it or throw rubbish in it. You are supposed to clean it, water it. And you come and dig it and what is this? فَحُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَبْغُونَ. Do they want the way of jahiliyyah? This is ignorance. Wallahi, ignorance. And look today, what happened to them? Everybody who comes up and fight them and say evil against them, Allah destroys them. They will never stand on their feet. Allah said in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. ألا إن أولياء الله. Indeed, those whom Allah has given them the position to be close to him, because they were obedient to him, because they were keeping his teaching, because they were good. When the dunya fear come, they are never frightened. They are only frightened of their qiyamah, of their questioning. They do everything and still they are frightened of the day of judgment. We are not frightened from the day of judgment. That's why we do every haram. But when it comes to the dunya, the police, the court, the judge, your money, we are frightened then. When it comes to dunya, the awliya are not frightened because dunya is nothing for them. They are only frightened of the day they meet their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are frightened when their prayer is delayed, when they're fasting, there is doubt in it. When their zakah is not measured properly, they're really frightened. We don't care. Inna Allah ghafurur rahim. But inna Allah shadidul iqab. Allah is swift in punishment and harsh. Alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaghun. Those who truly believed. And they were always avoiding what Allah has forbidden. Allah says, lahumul bushra. These ones, give them the good tidings. The good news, fil hayati dunya, in this dunya. Give me any name of somebody who's critical of the greatest scholars of Islam, their name is remembered. Never. There are many of them, even some of them are alive. Nobody even knows who they are. But these great people, they will be remembered to Qiyamah. If you travel anywhere in the world and say Imam Malik, everybody knows who Imam Malik is. Imam al-Shafi'i, everybody knows who Imam al-Shafi'i is. Abdul Ghadir al-Jailani, everybody knows. And I can give you many names. But the names of the people who are critical, who think they are the truth, but they are false, and they are following shaitan, their name will never be remembered. مَا بَكَتْ عَلَيْهُمُ السَّمَاءُ وَالْأَرْضِ. Neither the heaven nor the earth will ever cry over them. But the awliya, they will be remembered. For Allah says, لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. They will have the good news here and in the hereafter. لا تبديل لكلمات الله ذلك هو الفوز العظيم. This word can never be changed. This is indeed the true victory of these good men. These men, we should honor them. In this country, when I came to study, they honor their scholars. Shakespeare, this is their scholar. He's a good man. He wrote beautiful English. They study it. They make films. They make theater. They honor them. And we put down our scholars. What does it make sense? شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو. Allah bears witness. There is none worthy to be worshipped but Him. والملائكة are also witnesses. وأولو العلم. And the people of knowledge. People like Imam Malik, Abu Hanifa, Abu Hassan al-Shadhali, Abdul Ghadir al-Jailani. These are people of knowledge. Imam al-Ghazali. And you hear somebody who does not have any knowledge say, Imam al-Ghazali, I don't think his writing is good. I think there is... What do you mean? What do you mean? Do you understand what is written? A man whom Allah has opened for him to write books that too many people are benefiting from. Where is your input? Your input is only criticism about somebody who's died, and Allah will question you in the day of judgment of that. Umar ibn al-Khattab said, the messenger, peace be upon him, says, إِنَّ مِنْ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ لَأُنَاسًا. Indeed, among the servants of Allah, there are people, مَا هُمْ بِأَنْبِيَاءَ. They are neither prophet, وَلَا شُهَدَاءَ. They are not martyrs. يَقْبِطُهُمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ وَالشُهَدَاءُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. The prophets and the martyrs in the day of judgment, when they see them, they wish to be in their place. They wish. They are not prophets. They are not martyrs. They are normal people. But their position is so unique. Even the prophets say, who are these? Why are they in that position? يَقْبِطُهُمْ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ وَالشُّهَدَاءُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِمَكَانَتِهِمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Because of their position with Allah. They will come being carried عَلَى مَنَابِرٍ مِّن نُور. You know, in the day of judgment, some people will come walking. Some people will be carried. Some people will be riding. The Prophet said, Ali ibn Abi Talib will come riding a she-camel. Allahu Akbar. But there are those men who are not prophets, nor shuhada. The malaika are carrying them ala manabirin min nur. On urush, chairs made of light. Why? Because Allah loves them. Why? Because they loved him. يُحِبُّونَهُمْ وَيُحِبُّهُمْ أو يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ. He loved them and they love him subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man said to him, Ya Umar, من هم وما أعمالهم. Who are these people? And what do they used to do to be in this position? لَعَلَّنَا نُحِبُّهُمْ. Listen to the man. Perhaps we will love them too. قال عمر قوم يتحبون بروح الله عز وجل. People, they love people only for Allah, not because of their money or their status. Today we run after people who have a status. Even the children, when they realize a child in the school, in their home, there is a swimming pool, they will all become their friends. If their parents drive a beautiful car, they all want to lift in that car. If their father is an important person, they all want to be near to that person. We do that. We are weak. But these awliya, they only love you for Allah, not for anything else. يَتَحَبُّونَ بروح الله عز وجل. And he says, رضي الله تعالى عنه, يتحبون بروح الله عز وجل من غير أرحام بينهم. They are not linked through blood. ولا أموال يتعاملون بينهم. And they have no business between them or money. والله إن وجوههم لنور. By Allah Almighty God, their faces are lit with light. والله إن وجوههم لنور وَإِنَّهُمْ لَعَلَى مَنَابِرٍ مِّن نُورٍ. And indeed they will be in the day of judgment sitting on thrones of light. لَا يَخَافُونَ إِذَا خَافَ النَّاسِ. When people are frightened of the dunya, they are not frightened. وَلَا يَحْذَنُونَ إِذَا حَذِنَ النَّاسِ. And they will never be sad when people are sad. And then he recited, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءِ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْذَنُونَ. Indeed the awliya of Allah, no fear will ever enter their hearts of the dunya, loss. Neither they will be sad about it. Dunya is for dunya. Now, to finish, one of the greatest hadith I heard about this subject, Sa'id, the companion the one of the 10 people Allah promised Jannah. He said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, I hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, for Allah there are men and women, when they are seen, Allah is remembered. لِلَّهِ غَوْمٌ إِذَا رُؤُوا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. When you see them, you remember Allah. They don't remind you of dunya. They don't remind you of jahiliyyah. They don't remind you. Today I hear some of the younger people say, oh Sheikh, when I remember my jahiliyyah, forget about your jahiliyyah. Regret your jahiliyyah. One of the shurut, one of the reasons of tawbah to be accepted is you forget what you have done and you regret what you have done. And you promise Allah you will never do it. Not to think, oh, what I have done in jahiliyyah, and discuss it in the social media. May Allah forgive me and forgive you. May Allah guard me and guard you and give us tawfiq, and stand up and do your sunnah, inshallah. Shukran.